Hello, Jenny. Thanks for coming to see me. My name is Dr. Williams, one of the doctors at the gastroenterology clinic.
Hello, Dr. Williams. Thanks for talking to me today.
That's okay. I see that you have had some tests at the clinic and that you've been diagnosed with irritable bowel syndrome. Is that right?
Yes, that's right. I had a test and now they're saying that it's IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. I don't really know much about it.
I see. Yes. It is a lot to take in at once. I'll explain what happens with the condition in a minute, but I'd like to ask you a few questions first. Is that all right?
Yes, that's fine.
Can you tell me what's been happening with your bowels?
Well, I have this awful abdominal pain. It's like a colicky pain in my stomach. And it's actually really embarrassing because I keep passing wind and I keep going to the toilet as well.
It must have been very difficult for you. Can I just confirm with you that you've had a lot of abdominal pain and diarrhea, and you've also had a problem with wind? Is that right?
Yes, it is. It doesn't happen all the time, but when it happens, it's very painful.
Okay. You mentioned that you have diarrhea from time to time. Is it only diarrhea or constipation as well?
What do you mean? You have to have either diarrhea or constipation, don't you?
Not necessarily. There are a few different types of IBS. Some people just have constipation and some people have diarrhea. Other people have both together, which is very unpleasant.
Oh, right. No, I just have diarrhea, but as I said before, it's not all the time.
Okay, I see. So it's just diarrhea. How often do you have the diarrhea?
Well, I've had 3 or 4 bouts so far. I get terrible cramps as well.
And how long have you had these symptoms?
I've had the problem for around 3 months. Yes, it started around 3 months ago.
Right. I'll explain now what happens when you have IBS. Basically, irritable bowel syndrome is a digestive condition which causes uncomfortable bowel symptoms. People may have loose, mushy stools when they go to the toilet. I mean, when they have a bowel movement. Alternatively, they might have hard stools and strain when they go to the toilet.
Do they know what causes it?
No, they don't know the exact cause. That's why it is different from other bowel conditions. The structure of the intestines is quite normal, but the intestines appear to be oversensitive at some times. That's what gives you the bloating and intestinal spasms.
I see. Yes, I get bloating a lot. What about my diet? The doctor mentioned something might be wrong with my diet.
Yes, that's right. There are certain foods which make the condition worse. Can you tell me what your diet is like? What kind of foods do you tend to eat?
Actually, I always thought that I had a good diet. You know, I try to eat a lot of vegetables and I like whole grain bread. I thought that was the best thing to do, but now I don't know what I should eat.
A small amount of fibre in your diet is important to keep your bowels moving properly. But you will need to cut out high fibre foods if you can. It's a good idea to increase the amount of water that you drink as well.
Okay. Is the fibre in my diet giving me the bloating?
No. That tends to be from gas-producing foods like cabbage, for example. I'll give you a patient information leaflet on the foods which you should avoid to make it easier for you. Then you can try to avoid foods which cause you problems.
I see. They told me that my intestine was normal after the colonoscopy, so it was a bit confusing.
The problem is that the intestines in IBS are overly sensitive, and this seems to result in either constipation or diarrhea. Some people report that there are things which trigger bouts of IBS. You mentioned that your symptoms started around 3 months ago. Can you think of anything which was happening at that time?
Yes, I started a new job around then. It was really stressful, especially at first. I have a lot of responsibility and I work long hours too.
I see. So what you are saying is that the symptoms seem to coincide with your new job?
Yes, I suppose they did. Could that have something to do with getting IBS?
Yes, it could be part of the reason why you started having the episodes of bowel problems. When you feel tense and you can't relax, it can affect your bowels.
Oh, I see.
So apart from watching your diet and avoiding high fibre and gas-producing foods, it's a good idea to think about some ways that you can reduce the stress in your life. Yoga and meditation are good ways to reduce stress. Have you ever tried either of these?
No. And to be honest, I don't think I'd like to. They don't appeal to me at all.
Okay. What about going for a walk after work?
Well, that sounds a bit better. It doesn't sound very relaxing to me, though.
If you listen to some calming music as you walk, it can be quite relaxing. Would you be willing to try it? It really is a good idea to learn to relax, as it has a positive effect on IBS, especially after a stressful day at work.
Okay, I'll give it a try. Anything to stop those awful cramps.
That's great. I'll give you the leaflet about IBS now. Try to go for some gentle walks and see if that helps you. There is a phone number on the leaflet for the IBS support group. You might find that helpful too.
Right, thanks. That might be very useful.